The Good and the Beautiful Math, Old versus New. Let's jump in. Right away, you can see that the old discontinued version has two books. The new Simply Good and Beautiful Math has only one book. The second obvious difference is the binding. This is a spiral bound book, and it is not a continuous spiral. It has the little stops right here. That tends to be a problem sometimes as you get really heavy into use of your book. So with the new version, they are trying out a lay flat binding. You can see we've broken it in pretty good during our flip through, which if you're interested, I will have linked below in the description box. Another obvious difference, this one is vertical, this one's horizontally laid out. It's got the same logo and everything, the same feel. They're just a whole new design for a whole new curriculum. Let's take a look at the differences inside. First page, all kinds of information for parents before it gets into section one. The new one has table of contents and about this course, frequently asked questions, jumps into the overview and straight into the lessons. So what I love about the spiral binding is that we can easily flip it over and focus on what we're looking at. With this lay flat version, you get to see it all right there. So lesson one, in the old version, you have a page for the daily dose. Now this is only in the first lesson because they're kind of explaining how to do the daily dose. This isn't normal. We'll compare a later lesson as well to get a better feel for that. In the new one, there's no big daily dose. It simply has the child count by tens from 100 to 300. It's just kind of like a small review. We'll see if that stays the same. Lesson gives us the work, an optional activity, worksheet, and a bonus activity. For the new one, we have the lesson work all the way through here, independent review, and then it goes into lesson two. For both of these, the parent instruction is in blue. So here it tells you what to do, what to get out, what to do in each thing, and right here it's telling you what to do in blue as well. Lesson $37. Over here we have commutative property, checking addition with subtraction. Different lessons in both books, and I've seen parents ask, what if we're in the middle of the old version and want to switch the new one, can we? My kiddo who's going to use level two is currently in level one of the discontinued version. She's just going to finish that up and then jump into level two when she's done with it. Okay, so lesson 37. Here's the daily dose. It's half the page. Over here we have just a small little review. Then you jump into your lesson. Half a page here, a page here, student worksheet, and bonus independent activity. Here we have the one page. One page is it. You have the one page of the lesson and then the independent review. Here's another difference. There's no, this is your worksheet, this is your bonus independent activity, which I am super excited for because I often would get, do I have to do the bonus activity? This is the part you do on your own and that is it. It is. If you're interested in a closer look at this book, I have a flip through for it that is also linked in the description box below. In this one, we have the lesson on one page, independent review. That does indeed simplify. I mean, the goal with this is that it is less lesson time in there, but still just as concrete of learning. And I think that will be a big benefit in our homeschool. We just take a lot of time doing things. Okay, assessment. There's still a daily dose. Tells you what you need to get. Oral assessment and written assessment. And it still has a bonus independent activity. And that is it for that assessment. Honestly, I don't mind the layout because it makes it feel less like an assessment for the child. Just feels like another lesson to them. They're just doing a different thing. This says it's for lessons 32 and 33, where this other one, it was just lesson 31. Read the following information to the child. Lesson 32, have the child complete all the exercises with purple headers only. Correct the work. If the child makes one or more mistakes in a section, explain the concept and check the orange additional practice checkbox for that section. Okay, so they're going to go through and do this portion, not these parts. Okay. Lesson 33, have the child complete all the orange sections that are checked. If the child still makes multiple mistakes, make sure the child understands why. All the principles will be reviewed again in upcoming units. If the child has only a few or no orange sections to practice, the child may spend the time doing math games or move on to the next lesson. So it seems like a lot in here, but I think what they're doing and why there's a lot in here is that they're giving you all of the visuals you need on the paper rather than having you pull out manipulatives to do them, which I personally really like because you're not losing them while you're trying to pull out a penny for them to tell you that that's a penny. Here's the course assessment. There's no appendix. Simply Good and the Beautiful Math does not have an appendix. So in the discontinued version, your appendix includes things to use in the lessons on top of the stuff that you need from the box. There was just a lot of moving parts with the old one, which is fine. I didn't mind it, but I did get overwhelmed. I'm excited that it is all right here. Here's a ruler. You don't have to go cut it out from the back. Let's check out the two math boxes, shall we? First obvious difference, size. Also different. This is made out of cardboard, and this one is made completely out of wood. Look at how different those look. The difference in the simplicity is much appreciated for our experience with it. Not that this has been like terrible, but it has been overwhelming. There are less things that are needed. Here's the money. We have to get our own money here. Leaves your hands all stinky and everything. Nice plastic little coin. If you want a closer look at any of these things in these boxes, I have a video dedicated to this box. And in the Simply Good and Beautiful course flip through, this box is included. We have two dice here, one dice here. These fraction pieces are included in here. These cute little numbers and stars. We have all kinds of different numbers in here. All of the pieces are just simplified. If you want to see all of it, check out that video. I'll link it down in the description box. They worked really hard to make all of the games, everything you need right there on the page. Even still, with all of that, you have one book versus two books this size. So it's less paper being used and everything's still here. How amazing is that? I just can't say enough about how excited I am for this new Simply Good and Beautiful Math. Don't discredit this old one though. It's still a great program. We still highly recommend it. We still love it. In fact, my friend who let me borrow this level 2 is going to keep using it. She has multiple levels in it that she bought when it was on sale and she plans to do those with her daughter. Now I would love to know which of the two versions are you going to use for your kiddo? Please tell me in the comments down below. If you have made it this far in the video and appreciated the comparison, please give me a thumbs up down below. Liking and commenting on my videos helps me reach other parents who are looking for this information. If you have any questions or video requests, please drop them down in the comments below. I try to respond quickly and love being a part of your homeschool journey. If you're looking for the other math levels that we have, here's a playlist of those. The old version of level 2 is right here, the new version's right here, and here's a video that YouTube thinks you'll like. Just click on one of these and I'll see you over there.